Okay, I admit not really a landform, but the last thing on the fluvial processes is going to have to do with vegetation. Remember, this class, physical geography, is about the Earth's system, which includes the atmosphere, the lithosphere, the hydrosphere, the biosphere. So here's some biosphere for you. You may very well have noticed that there is a particular vegetation profile that you find along the banks of a river. We call that type of vegetation riparian vegetation. And you can see here in Utah along the Virgin River in Zion Canyon, the vegetation tends to be somewhat vertical because of the water source that it has. Riparian vegetation grows along the banks of a river, but it doesn't grow in the river. If it gets in the river, it kind of drowns the vegetation. But it's a type of vegetation that needs a lot of water. You're familiar with many of these types of plants, especially the trees. Willow trees, like the very famous weeping willow, is this type of vegetation, as is aspen and cottonwood, the one with the little white things that look like cotton come down out of the tree that float around in the air, dogwood. So all of these are all types of this sort of vegetation, riparian vegetation. If you take a look at this photograph right here, you can see it maybe even clearer because there is a clear, obvious vegetation profile along the banks of the river, which you can see in white. It's darker, it's greener, it's more vertical. In particular, when you compare it to where that orange arrow is at, and you can see there's vegetation over there, but it's much lower profile vegetation because it doesn't have access to water in the way that this stuff that's growing along the sides of the river does. That's the riparian stuff. Even in areas where you have dense vegetation, you can see that what's happening is there are different vegetative profiles. Right along the banks of the river, if you're looking carefully where the orange arrows are at, that's the riparian deciduous trees. And you can see up where the white arrow's at, there are evergreen needleleaf trees there. That would be like firs and pines, kind of like Christmas trees. Deciduous means that the plant loses its leaves. Most of the vegetation that grows along the banks of the river in the forms of trees has a tendency to be deciduous. You can see here in both of these pictures, the one on the right and the left, you can see that these plants that are the deciduous trees are changing colors. Those are the types of plants that do that. On the right-hand side, if you look in the background, you can see the evergreen forest. Well, the forest that's in the foreground is closer to the riverbanks. Then you can see, obviously, this is the Niagara River right there on the left-hand side. You can see that vegetation is right next to the river. I'm not sure if I've told you this, but I'll tell you now. The reason that the plant changes colors, that the leaves change colors, is this. In the spring, when the days start to get longer, the temperatures begin to warm up, and the sun is at a higher angle in the sky, the tree senses this. And it begins to put buds on the tree, which then eventually turn into its leaves. The plant produces chlorophyll, which is a dark green. Remember, in order for a plant to go through photosynthesis and to survive, it has to absorb sunlight and carbon dioxide in addition to nutrients from the ground and water. This is kind of what it eats. And that dark green that is chlorophyll is really good at absorbing sunlight. Remember albedo, high albedo, and low albedo? High albedo reflects sunlight. Well, this would be absorption of sunlight, so it would be low albedo. And so the plant produces lots and lots of chlorophyll during the summer, and the plant's very green and lush. But when fall comes around and the sun begins to go lower in the sky, the days shorten and the temperatures go down, the plant senses that, almost like it knows it's happening. And when it senses that, the plant begins to pull its energy in towards its core, towards its trunk. Because let's face it, the plant can survive with its trunk. It can't survive as just a leaf and without the trunk. So it begins to pull its energy in towards the trunk, which means it stops producing chlorophyll. When it stops producing chlorophyll, get this, all of those colors The reds, the yellows, and the oranges, they're always in the leaf. Always, always, always there. It's just that what happens is when the plant produces lots of chlorophyll, it overwhelms those other colors. And when fall rolls around and the plant begins to produce less chlorophyll, these other colors, the reds, the yellows, and the oranges, pop out. Then eventually the plant doesn't even want to hold on to the leaves at all, and it dumps the leaves and it pulls all of its energy into its core, into its trunk, and it waits for the winter. And then once the winter is over, it begins to produce the chlorophyll and the leaves again.